today I'm going to show you how to make a glass fossil. So this is an example. You can gather some nature items, which are considered organic materials. Hot glass can be gathered and dripped over the materials. The materials, in this case, it's little branches and leaves, were burnt out from the hot glass, but an impression was left. So today I'm going to show you the steps that we'll be using to make your own fossil. All right, the first thing to do is to gather your nature items. And then once you have your nature items, you can arrange them. Once it's arranged, I'll go ahead and gather some hot glass. This is the furnace holding hot glass. There's a big crucible of molten glass. The glass is at 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. When it's hot, it acts very much like molasses, so you'll see me turning the metal rod. Here's the first gather. The glass is clear. It is so hot that it looks like it's orange. And I turn it constantly so that it doesn't drip off onto the floor. I'm gathering on what's called a punty rod. It's made out of stainless steel. A lot of the tools in the glass blowing studio are made of stainless steel because they're durable, they don't rust, and stainless steel has a higher temperature of melting than glass. So the hot glass can be on the stainless steel without melting the metal. I have my second gather here. In between gathers, I let the glass cool down a little bit so that the next gather sticks to it and doesn't drip back into the furnace. In a moment, I'll take that third gather of hot glass, let it drip over the organic nature items, and cut the glass. Since the glass is so hot, it'll cut just like you could cut paper.
Materials burn a little.
a flat tabletop piece or a hook can be added. So I'm going to prop this up in the bin. You can still see some of the materials are burning out. Remove the stress and prevent cracking. And those are the steps to make a glass fossil. Thanks.